So how can we really assess your biologic clock? Well, there's one other aspect of your aging that is crucial that affects your fertility, and that's the number of eggs you started out with. Because really, your best eggs are ovulated first, and your best eggs die first, and your worst eggs are the eggs that have lasted longer. And so, if we can just know how many eggs you have, how many you're born with, and therefore how many you have at any age, we can give you an idea how fertile you are. Now, certainly at age 40, a greater percentage of your eggs will be abnormal. But if you have a lot of eggs at age 40, you'll probably have enough normal eggs to be able to get pregnant. Because the abnormal eggs just won't help you, but the normal eggs will be able to help you, and you'll be able to get pregnant and have a baby as long as you have a lot of eggs. So that's where this new test called antral follicle count can make an enormous difference. So let me go through this graph again so you'll understand it a little better. You're born with about 2 million eggs, and then you have about 400,000 eggs by the time you're age 18. Your optimal fertility is somewhere in your early 20s, and your fertility gradually goes down, even in your 20s. And there's a dramatic drop in percentage-wise in fertility at age 37. At the same time, there's a dramatic drop in your number of eggs. The average woman becomes infertile at age 41. Now, that doesn't mean everybody will be, but at least 50% of women are infertile by age 41. And then at least 50% of women go through menopause at age 51, and that's about 10 years later. So that's the general life cycle for an average woman. But are you either below average or above average is what you need to know for planning your life. Now, here's just a sample of an ovary, a cartoon of an ovary at any given time. And at any given time, you have these early primordial follicles, and that just represents resting eggs that are doing nothing, and they're safe. But about 30 a day or 1,000 a month leave that primordial stage and start developing. And eventually they lead to an ovulation, and you ovulate one egg every month. Now, what happens as that is developing is that the egg is getting bigger and it's developing a follicle. And then once it's a mature follicle, it can ovulate. Now, this is just a complicated diagram of the various changes in your hormones during your menstrual cycle. Recognize that these hormones, FSH, LH, estrogen, progesterone, only affect that egg that is about to be ovulated. But that egg that's about to be ovulated, if you look at this chart, began its development 85 days ago. So while you're having your current menstrual cycle, the egg you're about to ovulate in your current cycle began its growth and development about 85 days ago. So during your ovulation, you're only releasing an egg that started growing that left its primordial phase 3 months ago. So if that egg isn't ovulated, if you don't ovulate that egg, if it isn't stimulated by the hormone FSH from your pituitary gland, it dies. And in fact, about 30 eggs every day die. One of those eggs that is rescued by the hormone FSH is the egg that's going to be ovulated 14 days later. But recognize, every single day, 30 eggs are entering that stage of being prepared for ovulation, and 30 eggs are dying. This is just a graph that kind of shows you that the eggs begin to grow without any hormonal stimulation 3 months before your ovulation, and then there's this brief window of pituitary secretion of FSH just when you're about to menstruate, and that recruits follicles and eggs, and one of those 30 eggs recruited on that day is going to develop into the egg that you ovulate. Well, why do I mention all this? Because you have so many resting follicles, or resting eggs in your ovaries, and the fertility of the egg you ovulate is related to your age, but it's also related to your total number of eggs. And as you age from age 18 to age 28 to age 38, the number of eggs that are left in your ovaries goes down. And we can count the number of eggs in your ovary by doing a simple ultrasound antral follicle count. In other words, when you have a simple ultrasound, the doctors are usually looking for cysts or tumors or fibroids or some kind of gross pathologic problem. But they almost always neglect to look at the tiny little follicles that look like just little holes in your ovaries, very, very, very small follicles. And if they were to count those follicles, and we call that the antral follicle count, if we count those follicles, some women have a very low count, even at the young age of 27 or 28 or 30, and some women have a very high count. So the green line here just represents the average antral follicle count over a large group of women at different ages. And we know the average antral follicle count is going down. But some women have a high count at any given age, and some have a low count. And that antral follicle count is what tells us how big your ovarian reserve is and whether you're one of those 28-year-olds that's still fertile or whether you're one of those 28-year-olds that better start worrying.